Good morning. In this lecture video, I am going to explain functions of I/O ports. As we know, we have 32 I/O lines. They are organized as a 4 8-bit port. So, in this lecture video, I am going to explain the functions of each port. So, they can be used as an input port or output port. All this we will explain. Okay, you know, built-in I/O circuitry connects 8051 to outside world. That means we can connect any external devices such as sensors, or we can connect to the output device such as LCDs. And function depends on, whether they are behave as an input or output depends on what physically connected to the pin and how it is programmed, what software commands are used to program the pin. So, and these factors are completely under the control of 8051 programmer and circuit designer. Whether it can be used as an input or output, it's completely under the control of 8051 programmer and designer. And pin can be used as a single operation, that is I/O, or it can be used as an address pins for additional memory access, or it can be used as a together old port as a parallel port, or some of the port pins can be used for serial communication by using an alternate pin assignment. And each port has a D-type output latch for each pin. That means SFRs for each port is made up of 8 latches, 8 D-type latches, which can be addressed at the SFR address for the port. And data on the latches need not be same on the pins, data on the pins, they are different. Now we'll see port 0. Address of port 0 is 80H. This is the bit assignment. This is X address 80, and these are the bit addresses. So for lowest significant bit, 80, 81, like that up to 87. So this is P0.0, P0.1 up to P0.7. In general, we can say P0.x. X can be 0, 1 up to a 7. Remember, port 0 address is 80. Now, again, the pin may serve as an input, output, or used together as a bidirectional low order address bus data bus for external memory, to access external memory. And see, this is the diagram. As I said, each pin have a D-type latch. Port latch, D latches, and to this D input internal bus is connected, and this CL means clock pulse. Here we apply a write to latch, and then these are the alternate functions. As we know, these pins can be used as a address bar data. So this is another read latch pin and control signals. And see, this to read the latch content, one buffer is connected and it is under the control of read latch bit. This is called buffer. And then this is a port pin. Here X can be 1 or up to 7. And these two are the FETs, field effect transistors. So in between this, we are connecting into the pin. And then this is a control logic. So output of this control logic is connected to gate pin of lower, this we call as lower FET, and this one we call as higher upper FET. So to the gate pin of lower FET, output of control logic is connected. And input to the control logic is output of a D latch, complemented output of a D latch. And another input is complement of address bar data pins, And another input is control signal. It decides, this control logic decides whether this pin behaves as an I/O pin or address bar data pins. And this address bar data pin and control signal is connected to one AND gate. Output of AND gate is connected to gate pin of upper FET. And to read the pin, see, this is the buffer to read the latch, and this is the buffer to read the pin. So to this buffer, input is port pin and output is connected to internal bus. and it is under the control of a read pin data. Whenever it is 1, connection will be established between the internal bus and port pin. So this is the circuit diagram. Now let's analyze this. When it behaves as a address bar data and when it behaves as a IO. So whenever control signal is 1, it behaves as a address bar data. Okay, that means it is connected to output of the control logic that is connected to lower FET is connected to output of NOT gate. In turn, it is connected to address bar data. Suppose if it is 0, it behaves as a IO pin. Then output of a control logic is connected to output of the latch, complemented output of the latch. Then it is connected to gate pin of lower FET. So if it control signal is 1, it behaves as address bar data. If the control signal is 0, it behaves as IO pin, input bar output. Together we can say this is our control logic. This is our control logic. Input to this is output of NOT gate, that is input to the NOT gate is address bar data, and another one is control signal. Its outputs are connected to two FETs, upper FET and lower FET. Okay. Now we'll analyze how it behaves as a address bar data and IO. As you know, when a control signal is 0, it behaves as a IO. That means when control signal is 0, output of the AND gate is 0. If one input of the AND gate is 0, whatever may be other input, output is 0. So thereby, output of AND gate is 0. So gate pin of upper FET is 0. That means it is off. Upper FET is off. Then gate pin of lower FET is output of the latch. Okay? Output of the latch. Okay. So upper FET is up, lower FET to the gate pin, output latch is connected. Okay. Now whenever it is 1, say one input to the AND gate is 1, okay, then output of AND gate depends on other input. Other input is address bar data. So again, gate input of lower FET is address bar data pin. So when it is on and off, it depends on address pin. Here also upper FET, when it is on and off, it depends on address bar data pins. So lower FET on or off based on the address bit. Okay. So now we'll verify individual when it functions as an input and when it functions as an output, and later we'll discuss how it can be configured as a address bar data. So for a input function, input function means we are receiving the data. We are receiving the 8051 reads the data from port pin. So for that we must write 1 to the corresponding latch by the program. To program we must write 1 to the latch. So thereby it is turning on the lower FET. Turning off the lower FET and causes pin to float in high impedance state, essentially connected to input probe. Now let's verify. As you know, when the control signal is 0, upper FET is off. So it behaves as a IO pin. Now, as I said, we should write 1 to the latch, means we should make D is equal to 1. When D is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1 and its complement is 0. Q bar is 0. When Q bar is 0, that is in turn connected to lower FET. So, gate pin of lower FET is 0. If it is 0 means it is off. It is off means open circuit. Open circuit. Now see, the pin floats. Pin floats in high impedance state, essentially connected to input buffer. That means pin is connected to input buffer of read pin. So here, based on this control pin, then read is, whenever read pin is equal to 1, port pin data is available on the internal bus. That means the connection is established. Okay, to receive the data from pin. From pin, we should write 1 to the latch. Similarly, make it is output function, that means 8051 writes data to the port pin. So we must write the 0 to the corresponding latch by the program. Then turning on the lower FET causes the grounding the pin. Latch is programmed to one still float. Thus, external pull-up resistors requires to supply logic 1 when using port as an output port. So let's verify again, upper FETs of synth control signal is 0. And whenever D is equal to 0, Q is equal to 0, Q bar is 1. When Q bar is 1, that is connected to lower FET. So gate pin of lower FET is 1, so it makes on. When it is on, it makes a short circuit. It makes a short circuit means it is connected to ground pin. It is connected to ground pin. So provides 0 to port pin through ground pin. Clear na? So we provide 0 to the pin. Writes 0 to the port pin. Now next question is how to write 1 to the port pin. 1 to the port pin. So to write 1 to the port pin, we need D is equal to 1. So Q is equal to 1, its complement is 0. And 0 is connected to the lower FET, gate pin of lower FET, thereby it means half. Half means open circuit. Open. On means closed circuit. Half means open circuit. So now again it enters into float, I impedance state. It will be float in I impedance state. So causes pin to float in I impedance state. So that is why we need external FET puller to provide 1 to the port pin. To use pins as both input and output, each pin must be connected externally to 10 k ohm pull-up resistor. So this is external pull-up. Remember, port 0 doesn't have internal pull-up, so we use external pull-up to provide 1 to the port pin when used as an output pin. Okay, so because port pin, port 0 is an open drive. So next we will discuss how it behaves as an address bus data in the next video.